Dear students, good morning to everybody. In the last class, we have discussed regarding that is what are amines, what are their classifications, and we have given that is IUPAC name of this different type of amines. Today, we will start regarding the methods of preparation of aliphatic amines and also that is aromatic amines. But before going to that, we have to discuss regarding some of these isomeric forms, that is isomerism that occurs in case of that is amine, that may contain 2 marks or 3 mark question. The question is, what are the different that is isomerism in amines? Amines, they have the ability to show that is position isomerism, that is chain isomerism, that is metamerism, also that are the ability to show that is metamerism, that is optical isomerism and also functional isomerism. For example, if we cite one example, C3H9N, the question is, write down the possible isomers of this compound C3H9N. Write down the possible isomers of the compound C3H9N and name these compounds. We have to give the name of this compound, but before that we have to analyze what are the different type of compound that will be from this formula C3H9N. So if we write down that is CH3, that is CH2, that is NH2, that is carbon 1, 2, 3 is there. Hydrogen 3 plus 2, 5 plus 2, 7 plus 2, that is 9 is there. And nitrogen, that is 1. So this is the formula for that compound C3H9N. And if you write down this possible that is isomers again, and you have to name this compound 1, 2, 3, that is propanamine, and NH2 group that occurs at the position 1. And if you take that NH group at the position 2, then CH3, CH, NH2, CH3. 1, 2, 3, that is propan to amine. Then what is the relationship between these two isomers? All these two compounds, they are having the same chemical composition, that is C3H9N. All these two compounds, they are having the same chemical composition, that is C3H9N. But the first compound that is named as propan-1-amine. Second compound that is named as propan-2-amine. So the relation between these two, that the change of the position of that amine group, NH2 group, whether that is present at carbon atom 1 or at 2, that is position isomers. That is position isomerism. And if you write down this one, that is CH3 NH, that is C2H5. CH3 NH C2H5. Or we can write down this as, that is CH3 bond N, CH3, that is CH3. Count the number of carbon, hydrogen and nitrogen in all these four formulae. In the first compound that contains same C3H9N, second also C3H9N, and the third one C2C1, that is C3, 5 plus 1 plus 3, that is also 9, and nitrogen 1. And in this case, carbon 3, hydrogen 9, nitrogen 1. So all these compounds that is having the same chemical composition, that is C3H9N. But what is the difference? What is the difference between all these four compounds? So the first compound that is named as propan-1-amine, That is the example of that primary amine. Primary amine. Second one, that is propan to amine. So the relations between these two, these are the examples of position isomers. These are the examples of that position isomers. Then these are also defined as that is primary amine. This is the example of that secondary amine. This is the example of that tertiary amine. Why? Two hydrogen atoms of that ammonia, that is replaced by two alkyl group, that is ethyl group and methyl group. Two hydrogen atoms of that ammonia, that is replaced by that three alkyl groups. Three hydrogen atoms are replaced by that three alkyl group. That is tertiary amine. Tertiary amine, second amine, these are the examples of that primary amine. Then how to name these two compounds? How to name it? That is, if this group is not there, then that is your methanamine. If this group is not there, C2H5NH2, then it is ethanamine. So, whether we have to take methanamine as the parent or ethanamine as the parent, the large chain that is taken as parent, that is ethanamine, C2H5NH2, that is ethanamine. So, from that ethanamine, the hydrogen atom from that nitrogen is replaced by that methyl group. So, that is named as N-methyl ethanamine. N-methyl ethanamine. So, that is named as N-methyl ethanamine. Then how to name this that is tertiary amine? That is, if these two groups are not there, then that is known as methanamine. And from that methanamine, two hydrogen atoms are replaced by that two alkyl group. N-methyl, 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 N-N-dimethyl, methanamine. So, the C3H9N, that compound C3H9N, that will explain for which type of compounds. The first compound, that is propan-1-amine, propan-2-amine, that is N-methyl ethanamine, or N-N-dimethyl methanamine. So, if we'll take the examples of this one, or this compound, and this compound, they will be treated as, that is, functional isomers. They will be treated as functional isomers. Why? Because first one primary amine, this is secondary, and this is tertiary. So, amine, the question is just like this one, that may contain 2 mars or 3 mars. This may be your question, or that may be C4H11N. We have to write down the possible isomers of that compound, either that may be primary, secondary or tertiary, or there is a change of the positions. And from these compounds, this compound has the ability to show, that is optical isomerism. This compound has the ability to show that optical isomerism because this nitrogen atom is sp3 hybridized. For example, CH3, NH, that is C2H5. Nitrogen atom that contains lone pair of electrons, that is sp3 hybridized carbon nitrogen atom. That is sp3 hybridized nitrogen atom. So, that is having the pyramidal structure. Nitrogen atom at the center, lone pair of electron, CH3, that is H, and C2H5. So, if we'll take, that is mirror. CH, this compound has the ability to show. This compound not show because all the other three alkyl groups, same methyl group. So this is your, this will act just like the asymmetry center. that contain that is nitrogen atom that is attached to lone pair of electron, methyl group, hydrogen and ethyl. Methyl, hydrogen, ethyl and lone pair of electron. And if you take that mirror, this is a pyramidal, pyramidal structure. And if you take the mirror in this case, then what will the structure? N, C2H5, that is CH3, that is H and lone pair of electron. So this is the optical isomer. Optical isomer. So what are the probable structures for this? You have to write down all these. For this 3-mark question, you have to write down all these three. Or that is this type of compound and also the optical isomers that is shown by that amine. So this is the C3H9N. C3H9N. These are the different isomers of that compound. So that are the ability to show position. That are the ability to show that is functional isomerism. Or they are the examples of functional. Primary amine, second amine and tertiary. And also that is optical isomerism. So this is regarding that isomerism that occurs in case of amines. So next, regarding the methods of preparation of that primary amines. Methods of preparation of primary and second amines. That is aliphatic amines. First we'll see the methods of preparation of that aliphatic amines, that is open chain amines. So methods of preparation. So the first method, that is reduction of nitro hydrocarbons. Reduction of nitro hydrocarbons. So the general formula for the nitro hydrocarbon, that is RNO2. Nitro hydrocarbons that having the general formula RNO2. RNO2 that has been treated with 6H. So these are from that TN and HCl, SN or HCl or Fe and HCl. From this will be cheaper one. Instead of that TN and HCl, nowadays we are using that Fe and HCl because iron is cheaper than that TN. So RNO2, nitro hydrocarbon that has been reduced with TN and HCl because it has the ability to form SNCl2 or SNCl4. And hydrogen atom that gets released. And that hydrogen atom that helps in this addition process. Therefore, this compound will act as reducing agent. Similarly, we can take that Fe and HCl. So these are the reducing agent. So nitro hydrocarbons that has been reduced with TN and HCl and Fe and HCl. So NO2 group will be changed to NH2. NH2 plus, that is 2 water. So nitro hydrocarbons they have been treated with TN and HCl. These are reducing agents. They will provide that hydrogen atom and there is the formation that amine, that is primary amine, will be formed. For example, nitroethane C2H5NO2. Nitroethane that has been treated with TN and HCl, 6H, same reagent. So instead of that TN and HCl, we can take that Fe and HCl because iron is cheaper than the TN. Nowadays, this reducing agent that is used. So nitroethane that has been treated with TN and HCl, that the formation that hydrogen atoms and this NO2 group is changed to NH2C2H5 NH2 plus 2 water. There is a formation of that ethyl amine. Similarly, if we'll take the example of that is nitrobenzene. Reduction of that nitro hydrocarbons we have explained regarding the methods of preparation of that allopathic. Simultaneously, if we analyze regarding the methods of preparation that aromatic amines, that is your aniline. For example, aniline that is produced by the redox of nitrobenzene. That is nitrobenzene. Nitrobenzene that has been treated with tin and HCl. Tin and HCl. Nitrobenzene that has been treated with tin and HCl. There is a formation of that is aniline. NO2 group is changed to NH2 plus 2 water. If we take the same reducing agent, if there is a presence of that 2 NO2 group, two NO2 group are there. For example, ortho dinitrobenzene. Two NO2 groups are there. So that is reduced in presence of tin and HCl. Tin and HCl. That has been treated tin and HCl. What will be the product? Both of the two NO2 group. 12H is required. Both of the two NO2 group that will be converted into NH2. This will be converted to NH2. This will be again converted to NH2 with the release of that water molecule. Mark it. Whether there is the presence of that NO2, one NO2 group or two NO2 group, that is reduced to form, that is NH2. NO2 group is converted into NH2. But if this compound that has been treated with ammonium sulfide or ammonium bisulfide, NH4HS, that is one of the selective reduction. NH4HS, that is selective reduction, among these two NO2 group, only one NO2 group that is converted into NH2, leaving behind one NO2 group as such. One NO2 group that remains as such, but one NO2 group that is converted to NH2. One NO2 group that is converted to NH2. Mark this one. This is one of the selective method. Selective reduction. This is selective reduction. If ortho dinitrobenzene is treated with tin and HCl, both of the two NO2 groups that has been converted to NH2. If ortho dinitrobenzene that has been treated with ammonium bisulfide or ammonium sulfide, then only one NO2 group, only one NO2 group that is converted to NH2. So this is the difference. So this is regarding the method of preparation of that amines by reduction of that nitro hydrocarbons, that is nitro alkanes to form, that is primary amines, nitro hydrocarbons to form primary amines, that is aliphatic, and nitrobenzene compounds, they have been reduced to form that aniline. And this is one of the selective reduction process. If that benzening that contain more than one number of NO2 group, if that is treated with tin and HCl, all the NO2 group that is converted to NH2. But whenever that has been treated with ammonium bisulfide or ammonium sulfide, then only one NO2 group is converted to NH2, leaving all the NO2 group as such. All the NO2 group that remains as such, only one NO2 group that is converted to NH2. Because this is not the powerful reducing agent, this is one of the selective reducing agent. So this is regarding the method of preparation by reduction of nitro hydrocarbons. Next method of preparation, that is reduction, second one, that is reduction of alkyl cyanide, that is alkane nitriles. Reduction of alkyl cyanides or alkane nitriles. So this reaction, that is otherwise known as Mendius reaction. this reaction that is otherwise known as Mendius reaction, methods of preparation, that reduction of alkyl cyanide, reduction of alkyl cyanide or alkane nitriles by that is lithium aluminum hydride. So alkyl cyanide, that is having the formula R bond C triple bond N, that is the formula for that alkyl cyanide or alkane nitrile. Alkyl cyanide or alkane nitrile. So this alkyl cyanide, so whenever that has been treated with LiLH4 lithium aluminum hydride, LiLH4, that lithium aluminum hydride, so this pi bond will break by the addition of hydrogen atoms. This pi bond again break that by the addition of hydrogen atoms. Then what will the formula? RCH2 bond NH2. That is the formula R bond C triple bond N. R bond C triple bond N. So that has been reduced with LiLH4, lithium aluminum hydride. That is treated with lithium aluminum hydride. So this pi bond will break by the addition of that hydrogen. This bond will break again by the addition of hydrogen. So what will the formula? RCH2 bond NH2. So there is the formation of RCH2 NH2. That is the formula for primary amine. This is the formula for that primary amine. NH2 from that NH3, one hydrogen atom that is replaced by that alkyl group. That is the formula for that primary amine. For example, methyl cyanide CH3 bond C triple bond N plus 4H. Methyl cyanide C triple bond CH3 bond C triple bond N plus 4H. So this bond will break by the addition of that hydrogen. CH3 bond CH2 bond NH2. So that is treated with LiLH4, lithium aluminum hydride. So there is the formation of this product CH3 bond CH2 bond NH2. Pi bond, bond will break by the addition of hydrogen. CH3 bond CH2 bond NH2. CH3 CH2 NH2. So there is the formation of that primary amine. So reduction of alkyl cyanides that gives rise to, or alkane nitriles that gives rise to, that the formation or gives rise to, that is primary amine. Second one, that is reduction. These are the primary amines. That is primary amine that will form. But if we'll take, that is reduction of alkyl isocyanide, alkyl isocyanide or alkane isonitriles, alkyl isocyanides R bond N double bond C dirty bond, alkyl isocyanide or alkane isonitrile that is reduced. So that is reduced 4H. The same reagent LiLH4, that the formation of this product R NH bond CH3, that is secondary amine. Mark the difference between these two reduction process. Whenever alkyl cyanide or alkane nitrile that is subjected to reduction in presence of, that is lithium aluminum hydride, that the formation of that primary amine. And whenever secondary, or that is alkane isonitriles or alkyl isocyanides, they have been reduced, that the formation of that secondary amines. Mark the difference. Alkyl cyanide that is reduced to form, that is primary amine. Alkyl isocyanide that is reduced to form secondary amine. For example, CH3 bond N double bond C D T bond plus 4H. LiAlH4. That the formation of CH3 bond NH bond CH3. So C2H5N double bond C D T bond plus 4H. That the formation of that is LiAlH4. That the formation of C2H5NH bond CH3. That the formation of that secondary amine. 2-degree amine will be found. In this case, primary amine will be found. Here the examples of that 2-degree amine, secondary amines. N-methyl-methanamine. N-methyl-ethanamine. N-methyl-methanamine. N-methyl-ethanamine. So that the formation of that is secondary amines. So this is regarding the reduction of alkyl cyanides and regarding reduction of that alkyl isocyanides. So alkyl cyanides under reduction will form primary amines, and alkyl isocyanides or alkane isonitriles, they will reduce to form that secondary amines. Next we will see, that is regarding the methods of preparation of that that is amines. Next one, reduction of that is acid amides. Reduction of acid amides. Acid amides, there have been the general formula RCONH2. That is acid amides, there have been the general formula that is RC double bond O NH2. NH2. That is acid amide, alkanamides. Acid amide, RCONH2, that is alkanamide. So whenever that acid amide that has been treated with LiAlH4, lithium aluminum hydride. So acid amides that has been treated with LiAlH4, so this bond will break by the addition of that hydrogen. This bond again break by the addition of that hydrogen. This bond will break by the addition of hydrogen. This bond again will break by the addition of that hydrogen. So what will be the product? RCH2NH2 plus water. RCH2NH2. So there the of the product RCH2NH2 plus water. There the formation of that primary amine. Primary amine will be found. So acid amides reduced with that is lithium aluminum hydride. There the formation of that primary amines. Primary amines are formed. For example, if we take acetamide CH3C double bond O NH2 plus 4H, that is lithium aluminum hydride LiAlH4 lithium aluminum hydride. So this bond will break by the addition of that hydrogen. This bond again will break by the addition of hydrogen. So the product will be CH3 bond CH2 NH2 plus water. So that the formation of ethyl amine CH3CH2NH2 plus water. So this is the formula for that primary amine. That the formation of that primary amine. So reduction of what are the reduction process that we have discussed? That reduction of that alkyl cyanide to form primary amines, that reaction that is Mendius reaction, or the reduction of that alkane isonitriles or alkyl isocyanides to form that is secondary amines. And similarly, we have explained again that is reduction of the acid amides, reduction of the acid amides to form that is primary amines. So these are the some methods. In the next class, we will discuss regarding the other methods of preparation of that amines. Thank you all.